common hockey game of the week, and we apologize to you for not doing Friday night's game, but...
Not really.
Not really. We're glad we didn't. Comets, a big loss. A tough one to take home to bed, that's for sure. But Doug Riggler, we got to the Wheeling Nailers in here tonight. And like you said, they're right behind us in points in the West. And this is now where we start to lay down the fabric. And still, Hodgman's still out. I don't know what the story is there, but he's still out. Sadlowski was a healthy scratch the other night. We got to start getting some more out of these players. I don't want to be like the newspaper people that have to write what they feel is the truth. But like you said, just out here in the hallway, we were talking before this interview here, that they've got to start doing the little things. They've got to start going to the net harder. They've got to start, they take their shots, do the peel off. You can't be doing that.
Well, I mean, going back to Friday night before it got real ugly in that game, it was a 2-1 game. We had a chance. Brady Shaw hit the post. Great shot, great effort. I honestly feel that if that went in, it's a different game. And even when it was 4-1, we had a 2-on-1. Shot got on net. Whoever was going with Camaras peeled off. Didn't go to the net. Goalie lost the puck, and the puck was laying there. If someone went to the net, it's a tap in 4-2. Change of momentum. But we've talked all year, you know, we feel we have the talent that we can really be competitive. We knew we were about middle of the pack at the start of the year, and that's exactly how we've been playing. But the guys just have to buy into doing the little things that you don't always want to do as a player. Go to those spots where you know you're going to get chopped and hacked, but it's going to be the difference in a game. And we got guys that do that on a consistent basis, but we don't have enough guys doing it. And Sid was a healthy scratch Friday night. That was more as a message, I feel, from coming from the coaching aspect. Hopefully he gets mad, whether he's mad at Gary or anyone else. Just go out and play like the old Sid. He's kind of struggled since he's been back. We need him to play like he can to make a difference.
Well, we can't be always going back to referring to last year's team or anything like that. We got to move forward, and we got to just play the game like I think we can. Shastma the other night, doing like the true captain, went out, and unfortunately it was in the third period. He had three great hits, when we say body checks, and he threw three great body checks, which made that player not be able to progress, to move forward. He nailed three guys in one shift. Now, if he could have done that late in the first period, it would have sent a message going into the second period that things are going to be different when it came out to that second period.
Well, and even going back, kind of analyzing it, it's easy for us sitting up here, but the thing that really stuck out to me, and I'm sure they watched it on video, was three of their five goals were right off of faceoffs where they won the faceoff. Kind of, they had a play that going off. The first time I could see that, okay, we got beat, they got us on that. But they had the same play on two of the other goals that they did the same thing, beat us to the puck, got the puck to the front of the net, had guys there and outnumbered us. Couldn't blame our goaltenders, even though we pulled the first one after three goals. I didn't think any of the goals were his fault, but you had to make a change just to try changing the momentum.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And we just have to have our guys basically shut up, quit whining, you know, none of this woe is me, oh, we got so-and-so hurt or so-and-so up in the AHL. Look around the locker room, play for each other. Don't play for the coach, don't play for the fans, play for each other, come out hard, and we have a team that can win.
Well, let's see what we can do tonight. We got the Wheeling Nailers here. Great time to nail the opposition off and get rid of them. Tough one expected tonight. Had a great crowd the other night, kind of blew it. Let's see if we can't do it. We're supposed to have a decent crowd, even the weather's kind of rotten out there, but let's see what we can't do. We got the Wheeling Nailers in here tonight, Sunday afternoon. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
If you have a hero in your life you'd like to recognize, visit Comets.com for more information. Please welcome tonight's hometown hero, Chief Petty Officer Lois Schenck. Chief Petty Officer Schenck has proudly served in the United States Navy for 17 years. She is originally from Angola and is now finishing up her Navy career in Fort Wayne as a recruiter. Through the years, she's been stationed in California, Japan, and Virginia. The Comet organization and our fans would like to thank you for your dedication to our country. Once again, please welcome Chief Petty Officer Lois Schenck.
Thank you.
Now, fans, please rise and remove your hats and welcome Allie Gertner with the singing of our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watch were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star spangled banner yet wave o'er the
Nice job by Allie Gertner. Very nice nice job there. Referees, let's go to the goaltenders, I guess I should say. Starting in goal for Wheeling. Looks like it's number 31, Jordan Ruby. He's got a 2.49 goals against average. He's played in 15 games. He's 6'1", 195, 27 years old. And starting in the other end for the Comets, Lucas Hapner, 3.07 goals against. He's played in 25 games, 6 foot, 205, 27 also. And referees assigned by the ECHL are brothers Christopher and Trent Williams. Christopher wearing number 62 and Trent wearing number 48. And Liam Sewell is the referee in charge, wearing the old orange armbands, as Otto says, the floaties. But again, Doug, I was saying about the last night's game, we talked to Gary Graham's uncle down there. Tough game to lose with the score, but to have 10,400 in here last Friday night was a real sorry situation, as I guess would put it.
Well, this year we've had a few games where we've had big crowds and we haven't got the results that we wanted. I think the last time we've had a home win is like January 12th, you know, so we've gone a while, you know, but the good thing is we've been getting points. We've grinded it out, even with a depleted staff, guys being called up. We've been doing pretty good on the road. Now we just got to toughen up at home. And again, I think it's more a mental aspect of it. And hopefully some of our guys got their crap together and are ready to play.
I'm glad you cleaned that up a little bit. Yeah, talking to Shane out in the hallway from doing the radio aspect, you know, he said if we could have played half well as we did the other night, as we did in Newfoundland, they played so well up there. I know they didn't get as many points as they would like to. They took every game to overtime. I mean, can't ask for much more.
Well, and the other thing that we've talked a lot about this year, really the way of the future now for this league is you need a good relationship in affiliation with an NHL team, that you're going to get, you know, 5 or 6 good quality players at this level, because the Comets are going to be fighting the uphill battle of recruiting good players. We can do it, but then when we recruit them, we're doing well, they get called up, and we don't have people coming back to replace them. And Newfoundland's got 16 guys that are there mainly through the Toronto organization, you know, that have a lot of experience, and so the depth they have, you know, and we went in and took 4 out of 6 points.
Yeah, not too bad, not too bad at all.
But we've always played well against the top teams. It's the teams that we're equal with or
right
behind us in the standings that we seem to play down to their standards.
Well, they got four scratches from the Comets. Sims, Gibson, Hodgman, and Halme. So let's see what we can't do here. We got Petrosale on the near side there talking it over with Alec Butcher. But Petrosale played well, I think, and good to watch him. Here's Phillips dumping it in. Nice hit right off the bat from Brady Shaw. Let's see if that's not going to mean something. There's a little bump there. Shaw coming back to pick it up defensively. And there's something you said, too. The forwards playing some defense, not just defensemen playing defense.
Well, and a lot of people, when they watch and they hear us talking, oh, defense is bad, we're not talking the defenseman or the goaltending. It's a team aspect. If you take care of the defensive side, offense will come.
Well, Cody Salt tried to put a little force there and taking the body. That was Campagna. Big boy, too. Here's Sidlowski dumping it in, hitting off the boards.
Throwing it in deep.
Shaftsman to the
far
side.
Got Shaftsman and Campagna with him.
Got deflected there.
This should be a good line.
Nice chip shot out of the zone. Lowney picks it up there. That's another thing. Lowney is usually outstanding. You didn't see him the other night. I wasn't really aware how he was even doing during the game. Comets keeping in the offensive zone pretty good here so far. Here's Lowney, pass over. Oh, nice job of putting it on the net.
Yeah, great play.
Good job by Binkley keeping it in. And that goes up in the netting. Should be a face-off inside to the right of Golden Jordan Ruby.
But a good first shift. Now we just got to carry it through all the other lines that when they come out. Thing I liked was that we went to the body every time they had the opportunity. And in the game, even from the NHL down, there's not as much hitting as there used to be. It's a little more wide open, and teams that can hit can throw the other team off.
Face off the right of Ruby. All that, and then they get thrown out.
Yeah, we just need our big guns, our leaders to produce and get some goals. We've been struggling on that end of it the last number of games.
Here's Ciro going in there after it, taking two guys with him. Nice job by Clark. Clark was a scratch the other night. Hate to see that. Garrett Clark wearing number 3. Played for Indianapolis 2 years ago, I think it was. Gave us a lot of fits. Nice clearing there of on the far side.
Yeah, get the puck out of our zone, not turning it over.
As they get into the zone, Ketzenberger's taking a body. Nice little pass.
Oh, there's a little hook.
No call.
No offside because we brought the puck back in.
82 Lisaway out there. Haven't seen much of him. Recent acquisition, I should say.
Good shot going to the net. Petrozelli.
I like that.
And he went there and stopped. Yeah, Lisaway played the other night. I noticed him out there, but it was one of those games where you didn't notice a whole lot of players because
not a lot to notice.
Well, when it went from bad to ugly.
Yeah.
You know, and then Adirondack just kind of put it on cruise and just kept dumping the puck in. And, you know, it turned into a perfect road game for them and made it nice and easy.
I was telling some people, yeah, the Comets scored right off the bat. Then Adirondack, then Adirondack. Are you kidding me? Yeah, it was 5-1 the end of the first period. Oh, man. Kind of one of those games you remember for the wrong reasons. Ooh, nice job, and we had somebody in front.
You're going to get a hooking penalty. Well, and that's the thing. We had someone right at the net. We keep doing that, we're going to win a lot of games.
Yeah, and this is nothing new. I mean, as a professional, you came into Fort Wayne knowing you had to do things like that.
Yeah,
it's not like it's something. Oh, Ed, that's a new idea.
Yeah, whether you're in juniors, squirts, mites, anything going up, that's one thing that was always ingrained in you. And if you're around the net, sooner or later the puck's going to show up.
Now, I'll tell you, Campagna is one of those guys that if it's in there, that area, he's going to get it. He's going to work on it. And he's one of those guys that do go to the net like that. Here it out to the point. Here's Binkley with it. Nice wrist shot. Shaw doing a good job right in front of the net.
Moving the puck all the way around.
It's almost, if we could have declined this power play, Comets are number 27 in the league, last in the power play.
And yeah, that was my joke Friday night. You know, some people, I said, can we just decline it?
Yeah.
Because I've had teams where I've coached in that where you're just struggling. And it got to the point where, can we just decline the power play? Because, you know, we're not doing well.
Yeah, Wheeling is 20th in the penalty kill. So to any advantage, that might be for us. We can't go anywhere but up. 27.
Well, and the thing is, you just got to start putting the puck to the net. You can't get too fancy. Just put the puck to the net.
Just like that. Oh, my gosh.
They make me look so smart.
You are smart. I keep telling you that.
Yo, and when a team's struggling, that's what you need to do. The great thing was we had someone go in front of the net. They were screening the goaltender. Just a quick wrist shot. The goalie went down trying to cover all the areas, went in the top corner.
Well, Lowney, he definitely made himself known tonight, scoring the first goal of the game. And top corner, too. But there's some traffic in front. And, you know, that's...
And that's so important because the goalies are so good that if they see the puck, they're going to get a piece of it.
Here's Sidlowski. Centers the puck, and Shasta one-handedly gets it out to Lowney. Lowney again. Oh, that gets tipped there. That gets into the corner of the Wheeling area. They just bring it in with Diffie throws it in the corner. Out to the point. Nice block.
Nice
here
block.
We got. Can we get a 2-on-1 maybe?
We got Sidlowski.
And they're going to be calling a penalty on that, no doubt.
Yeah, Shasta driving to the net. And again, it all started with Sidlowski blocking the shot. We kind of coughed up the puck down low. Lowney went to just throw it back behind the net. Every team that watches video knows we love to reverse the puck, go back the other way. Their guy got to the puck first, just threw it to the front, came all the way out to the point. The guy took a shot, but Sid paid the price, blocked it, went down.
Well, and Shasta paid the price too as he drew that penalty by putting the effort to go out to get the puck back.
But two of our leaders doing what they needed to do to lead.
Exactly, exactly. Face off the left of Ruby. Back to pick it up. Trey Phillips. Dropping it back like you say. Here's
Shaw. I was getting nervous on that.
I do too. Oh, it gets tipped.
It's tipped by our player. Nice play by their goaltender.
Control, not the front. Binkley. Can we get Binkley back? Ah. Trey Phillips doing a nice job there. Here's Shaw. Oh, can't get it. He wanted to get over to Binkley.
Get back.
Petrucelli back to pick it up.
But again, we had some good quality shots. Their goaltender come up with some big saves. Out shooting them 8-0.
This is what I'm not real wild about, but I don't understand what they're trying to do. Here we go. Here's Sidlowski. Campagna. Thought they were going to call it offside, and they did.
Yeah, one extra move, and the guy that had to move was our player, had to lift his back foot off. But the thing I like, we're trying to get the puck in the zone with a lot of speed. Sadlowski was carrying the puck up. He's seen Campagna coming off the boards. It's one of the adjustments I've seen that they've made. He's swinging around, but he's gaining speed.
Yeah, and he's a very fast skater for his size. Campagna, 6'4". He skates like a 5'9er would. Got tremendous speed. Sadlowski trying to force a play. Here we go.
Good job on just going to the body.
Oh, deflected. He just couldn't get a hold of all of that
one. Camaras just would kind of drifted a little too far. Thought the rebound was going to come out more on this side, and it came back straight out in front.
20 seconds to go on the power play. Just dumping it in all around on the near side. Sadlowski gets it back. Oh, right out in front!
Oh, Camaras just kind of fanned on it, just didn't get much on it.
But that's what you're wanting. Nice job by the goaltender.
But I tell you what, if they keep playing like that, there's going to be a lot of goals scored.
Well, I like him going to the net anyway. He's in the area. Off the boards. Come on, fellas.
5-on-5. Need a change. There we go.
You got Ciro with him, but he's too deep.
Good job.
Oh, that went off the skate of Saul. I'll take it. Ooh, and they're going to slow it down. Well, I thought
they went off a body.
I thought the goaltender picked it up. Going in as Kartzenberger's going to hang on to that.
Havner squared up to the shooter. Nothing to worry about there. No rebound.
13:21 to go in the first period. Comets up 1-0. Wheeling comes in here tonight with a 23-23 5-1 record, 52 points. They're ninth in the West. Comets come in here tonight with a 23-18, 3-4, with 53 points. They're number 8 in the West.
And I think Wheeling's played about 4 more games than the Comets have. So if we take care of business in the games we play head-to-head, we'll keep them behind us.
Yeah. Getting a lot of traffic in front of the Comets net. Back to pick it up, Batista. Petrucelli after it. Goaltender really coming out and forcing the play, Ruby. Well, there's, you got to take the body with the puck. Nice poke check.
There we go.
Here's Batista with it. Nice chip into the
Batista
zone.
Batista with going back to number 9.
Shaw.
Normally wearing 14.
Yeah, I was kept looking back there, and then Sims was... had been wearing 9. I thought, well, maybe they messed up. And I looked down, he's got a beard, and I know Sims didn't have a beard.
Well, at first I thought it was Krunk taking the face off.
That's what I thought. Then I thought, wait a minute.
No, that's number 9.
Yeah. Sadlowski getting pinched off there by Fox. Saul with a nice shot. Comes still have possession. Jasmine in the corner. He gets slashed.
Saying a few words that we can't really repeat on TV.
Sid loses it on the boards. That's all right. Nice job there on the boards with Clark taking the body. Oh, nice. Oh, two good moves there. And on his knee, making a nice pass. Campagna. Oh, just out of the reach, trying to pick that up. Dropping it back there was Lissaway.
Gain the zone.
Lissaway right in the blue line. As Camras is in the corner, gets blasted.
Good hit.
Yep. Nice tip. Oh.
Oh, nice play.
Yes, it was. It had Lissaway going to the net, wasn't it?
Yeah, Lissaway, and he had a nice backhand. He stayed with it. I thought it was going to sneak past the goaltender. And it didn't.
Face off inside the zone as Wheeling took it off its moorings. Doug played the days of the old nets that were anchored in there
good. They didn't move.
They did not move.
Seen many a guy mess up a knee, back.
Oh, yeah.
Because those things did not move.
These are pretty nice. They do dislodge sometimes a little too easily. Of course, they took that point out of the back there with Mark Howe getting severely injured.
And impaling himself.
Otto hates it when I talk about that. Where he impaled himself was what even worse. It was hard to go pop poo poo after that. Otto expressed himself there just moments ago.
Only but in our ear, so you didn't have to hear that.
Yeah, you didn't have to hear that one. Binkley just
that happens at least once a game with Otto with
yes,
us.
Yes, of course.
He gets a little fed up with us.
No icing. Or yes, no, it gets waved off.
Yeah, their guy was beating ours to the puck, so.
Lowney, nice cross check, no call. Jeez.
Yeah, sticking them.
Lowney working on the craw pretty good. Comets pick it up. Nice move. Nice. Camras. Oh, that was onside. Yep. I thought it was going to be off. But nice job by Camras taking him to the body. Here's Phillips with it. Nice. I like that just to flex it into the zone. Petruselli putting the force on there. Ah. Phillips, nice tip into the zone again by Batista.
And Shaw goes to the net and makes the goaltender hang on to it.
That's both forwards went up to the net there. That's good. I like to see this attitude. It's an attitude change, isn't it? So you can see that right now.
And I can guarantee you that's all they heard. You know, the last while is we got to play Comet hockey. And when we talk about that, it's the little things like going to the net, going to the body. You don't have to put someone through the board, but it's winning those little battles. This game is a game of little one-on-one battles, and if you win those ones, usually you're going to win the game.
Well, I hear rumors as far as that goes on Facebook, things like that. People say, oh, we need to get a new coach. Coach doesn't know he's doing da-da-da. Batista gets a spin around, gets it tipped into the netting. But there were a lot of there was a guy named Captain Video, they called him, in the NHL that had a very successful career with the New York Rangers, I think. And
Roger Nielsen
never played the game of hockey.
No.
And Gary didn't play. Gary played it, but didn't play it at a higher level. But knows the game, studies the game, has been a student of the game. You got to give the guy some credit. And there's a time that players that maybe played a few games in the American League coming back, they still got to listen to coach. They got to still listen to coach.
Well, things never change over the years. This game is very simple. You know, the coach is in charge. Yes, the buck stops on his desk, and he's the one that will pay the ultimate price if the team does really bad. But if the players will follow the game plan, whether we have a lot of talent or little talent, if they do it, we will be successful, or as successful as we can be. And then it's up to management, if we don't have the talent, to go find the talent. But it still comes down to when the game starts, the players know what they're supposed to do. They got to do their job.
Well, I was appreciative of you talking out in the hallway before about that, and I didn't really even notice it that night. You talked about those face-offs, how they picked those face-offs right off the bat, and we didn't correct ourselves to it. And you're right. I mean, they were up 5-1 at the end of the first period.
Well, and stuff like that, that's up to the players to notice out on the ice, to win those battles off the face-offs. Because it takes everybody, just not the centerman. We're going to get a holding or interference.
That looks like an interference right there. Petruselli going.
You know, in this, the game itself, you could have the best game plan in the world, but if the other team starts taking away what you want to do, it's up to the players to make that adjustment on the ice. They know what they have to do to adjust to it, regardless what the coach is telling them, that if you win your battle against who you're playing against, that's 1/5 done out on the ice. Then if everybody else on the line is doing their job, all of a sudden then you're winning the game.
Now Petrocelli going to the box for interference. 2 minutes. K's have a, they rank 15th in the penalty kill, 83%. It's only better take advantage of that because, believe it or not, Wheeling ranked number 3 with the power play, 22%. So you got to shut these guys down when they get the power play.
Yeah, just don't let them set up.
Here's Saul going after it, taking the,
there we go.
Taking the body. Nice job throwing it all the way down.
All the way down and then get some new guys out there, skate hard.
1:25 to go in the penalty. Wheeling brings it out. They try to gain control in the offensive zone. Nice contact taking the corner.
Got to be careful.
Nice deflection. It's right on the line. Taking a look. Boy, he tipped it right there, just perfect.
Yeah, they're trying to set up to hit the guy in the slot. Got to keep taking that away. That's where, then the guy on the back door. Here we go.
They're working out of the corner.
Here's 2-1-2.
Batista would go right back to the middle. Oh, Shaw got a nice shot. Got deflected.
Got blocked by the defenseman. Get two fresh legs out.
30 seconds to go in the penalty.
We're going
to
get too many men.
Is that us or them?
Yep, it's us. Our guys jumped off the bench and got into the play too quick before everybody got off the ice. So,
Comets back in the box again. 29 seconds remaining in the Petrocelli's penalty.
You know, good call by the linesman. Actually, a pretty simple call. It would have been different if the play wasn't over there.
Right.
But our guys got right into the play and went to the body on the guy trying to get the puck.
Face off the left of Lucas Hafner.
So this is where we need our goaltender to come up big for us.
5-on-3. 29 seconds left in their first penalty. Out to the point. Controlling to Spinozzi. Spinozzi drops it off to Lynch. Nice nice takeaway there.
Jasmine chopping big time.
Oh, yeah.
But again, our defensemen were coming in and just cleared the front of the net. If Wheeling would have had someone paying the price in front, they would have scored.
Well, you got to watch out for Lynch, 27. Ooh, broke a stick there. Nice block there. Didn't know if he really meant to do it or not. Nice job by Shasma as,
That's kind of the attitude we need. Just don't give them any room.
Comet's still shorthanded for one more minute. Binkley tries to get it out, can't. Gets picked off by Fick. Fick with it. On the near side, back to Fick. Hirono, there's a good goal. That's what it picked off by Yates, his third of the season.
Yeah, their guy got position on Cody and what made that goal was their defenseman was shooting the puck for a rebound. Just to get the puck, and Hafner made a great save. Rebound came straight out towards the slot. Their guy was right there on the inside of Cody, had nothing but an empty net to put it in. And just like that, we're 1-1 game.
Both power play goals in this game.
You know, so regardless how much we outplayed them in the first 12 minutes of this game, we're at 1-1. So now we just got to keep going. We're playing well.
Well, Wheeling with a diverse team. Hirono from Japan. He's wearing number 9. He's got to watch for. He's a pretty decent player. Of course, they've had hockey in Japan quite a while. I know Doug Johnson played over there for a couple years. Makes his home at Fort Wayne, but played in Hokkaido and Hiroshima, I think. Going to the net.
He played over there with Daryl Sutter.
And who's the guy that recruited a lot of those players to do that? He was kind of a hockey icon out. Doctor something, or was
it? Oh, King?
No, not Dave King. I'm trying to think of the guy that Doug talked about. And as I looked into it, he had quite a bit of influence of being like a minister of hockey from out in Western Canada.
Claire Drake?
Yeah, that doesn't sound right out. I might think of it maybe.
Yeah, we'll have to look that up.
Next week. But, yeah, I can't remember who it was, but I know he had got Doug over there. Played a couple years. Doug had that Fu Manchu mustache that was rather intimidating.
Yeah, he is a big boy.
He's very strong guy. Coming back, picking it up, taking to the boards. Good job there. Not getting it out of the zone, though. There we go. Here's Saul. Nice. Ah.
Good job in just getting it out.
Coming back into the zone is Butcher.
And he scored short side.
Oh, boy. Now, there's the one you got to probably blame on the goaltender covering that post.
Well, he shouldn't get beat short side.
Nope. Wheeling going up 2-1.
You know, and again on that one a little bit, I look at Cody Saul. He got chopped, and he kind of was worrying a little too much about that and slow getting back. But, yeah, on that one, Hapner just got his kind of stand his ground, and it would just hit him.
Yeah. That's Butcher's ninth of the season.
You know, like that, two goals on four shots. Whereas we got one goal and 12 shots.
Yeah, you got to have a little better average than that. Yeah, switching off into the corner, out to the point. Ah. Ooh, boy, right there it is. Lowney was there to assist, but he got me in a little bit too late there.
You know, and you can kind of feel the energy has been drained a little bit in the building. And now it's just up to us to just keep going, because everyone's thinking like, oh, gosh, are we going this way again? You know, we played so well, and we have.
Yeah.
And we are. You know, but it's more the mental aspect of the game. We just got to get over that hurdle.
Yeah, out shooting your opponent 12-4 and you're behind. That's not a good sign. Here's Sadowski going into the corner, beating him, getting a control of the puck and getting a little bit deeper. There's a good sacrifice, and Shastma felt that as he's going to go off.
Took something into the throat or chin area.
He's going back to the dressing room. Nice tipped off to the camera, goes after it, puts a little pressure on. Oh, right there. And Lisaway had an opportunity, just wasn't really
in good position.
Yeah, good position there. Goaltender lost his helmet. And Clark not too happy with, Camrat's in there. We know from past experience, Doug Riggler, that Clark can take care of himself.
Well, their guy was driving to the net, and he shoved Clark back into Hafner. Kind of gave him a shot, and that's what Clark was going after the guy for.
And then Sol talking it over with LaCroix.
Trying to get his hand free. A lot of swinging.
These guys have played each other, so they know Little.
Cody landing a good one on him. Yeah, there's no love lost between these two teams.
No. Little size differential. LaCroix with the 6'1".
And he looks small.
Yeah.
6'1", good size.
Yeah.
So we'll see what comes out of all this.
Well, we're sure that Sol's going to the box for five. 4:49 remaining in period one. Comets down 2-1 to the Wheeling Nailers. I'll start out with Clark going to that, getting run into our own goaltender. Now, LaCroix did a pretty good job, though, considering the size differential.
Yeah, two strong boys. So, all even up.
Well, although we're down one goal, Doug, I'm impressed with what I've seen so far. You know,
well, we've played very well. And the danger that we always have when you're working that hard and getting that many chances and you only get one goal, they scored a power play goal, which they have excellent power play.
Right.
Because we took that extra penalty of too many men. Well, then all of a sudden they got the one, what I call a weak goal, because anytime a guy's shooting from the side like that, goalie should never get beat short side. Looks like they're coming down to scrape up some blood off the ice. So it looked like Cody kind of piled drive the guy face first down into the ice.
Yeah, back in the old days, they just scratch it.
But now everything's on the safety aspect.
Yep.
Can't even really see where it's at, but I guess it's there.
Nope. Oh, it's a little bit over here. A little bit over here.
You know, but we just got to keep going. We can't get discouraged because we've played very well. You know, they've had two scoring chances. They've scored on both of them. I'd say we've had good six scoring chances. We've scored on one. You know, we just got to keep going.
Yeah, it still should be a 1-1 game right now. That power play, it's tough to, you know, you're ranked number three in the league on the power play. It's tough to hold them off, but short-sided goal, that's, like you said, that's
that's on the goalie.
Well, big blame goes to the goaltender, unfortunately, but.
You know, because, like, even when I coach, when I tell my defensemen, if you keep them to the boards, if they score from the boards, that's on the goalie, especially if it's short-sided. Then we'll take care of that. But you don't want to let them into the middle of the ice where they have a good shooting lane.
Right.
And so many of these goalies, the butterfly style is that they start dropping as soon as the guy's going to shoot. Now a lot of these guys are such good shooters, they'll be always shooting high, putting it up around the ears, and sometimes you get lucky and catch it underneath the crossbar.
Yep.
And that's exactly where he put it. He didn't have a whole lot of space, but
no.
You know, sometimes it's better to be lucky than good.
Well, I haven't seen Shasta down there yet. I kind of tough to see from up here, but hopefully he's okay. He took that check in the corner there, and
I don't know if he took a stick or something. Might have got cut.
Might got popped on the ear. It looked like he was favoring that left side of his face, but
you know, so if he got cut, they'll stitch him up and he'll be back. So I think I see him on the bench, so he's back.
That's good.
Takes a lot to get a hockey player out of a game.
Especially with his history, that's for sure. Both teams full strength.
Just under 5 minutes left. Now we just got to go get one more.
Oh, goes wide. Nice shot there by Hirano. Batista off the boards. Picked it off there.
Here we go.
Phillips, nice job getting into the zone. Petrucelli, boy, that was right on the toe of Phillips. Being able to pick it off. Petrucelli putting the pressure on. Good effort there. They waved it off.
Yeah, their guy
the
was
icing. On the boards. There you go. Take the body, guys. Oh, here's Phillips on the boards again. Nice little cross check, no call. Kind of fell into that one, though.
Seskon kind of launching the guy.
Ooh, nice Nice dump into the zone, backhanded by Shaw.
Dumb penalty by Sid. Can't really do that right in front of the ref.
Yeah, a little tough there. Sean Sadlowski want to make his presence known there.
Now we just got to kill off this penalty before the end of the period.
Yeah, it's good to see, like you said, Chastner's out there talking to the referee now. And it's a tripping penalty to Sean. 3:39 remaining in period one. Comets down 2-1.
Lots of hockey left.
Decent crowd for a Sunday afternoon with a Daytona 500 going on.
And the weather was supposed to be worse than what it is. And coming into the game, it was kind of turning into that freezing rain.
Face off to the left of Lucas Hafner. Boy, yeah, watching the replay of that, I guess he did right in front of the referee. Jeez.
You know, and the guy just went to the body on him.
Matter of fact, Sean was so close to the referee, he probably could have taken his right hand to cover the referee's eyes and then tripped the guy. He was that close to him. Oh, thankful. Picked that one off.
Well, I think even a blind one would have saw that one, Otto.
Yeah, I think he probably would have. Otto, our cameraman, talking about how blind the referees can be sometimes. Ooh, they just barely tipped that in. Petrucelli putting some back checking pressure on. But Wheeling third in the league in the power play. The point.
They don't do anything real fancy. They just move the puck and shoot it.
I'm going to cover that up. Oh, a little extracurricular going there with the Krastenbergers.
Yeah, Chastman going in to give him a little facial. Little rub in the face with the smelly glove.
Chastman at 36, Doug. How much longer do you think he's going to play?
I think he still has another year in him, the way he's playing and the way he takes care of himself. And then you can fully expect that he's would probably go into coaching.
Yeah, there's no doubt.
Great organizational guy. Family's dedicated. He's got good family support.
Yep. Done a lot of moving in the last 20 years for hockey. Happy husband, happy wife, as they say. Probably not maybe that order. Yeah.
Happy wife, happy life.
Yeah, something like that. Blast from the point, got deflected. Shaw taking the body. Nice deflection in behind the net. Nice.
Good job.
Nice job by Shaw again, Doug, right in the slot. Cleared that puck.
Because Wheeling, they don't do anything fancy. They just put the puck into play.
Well, I guess. They're onside. 13 seconds to go in the penalty. That went up into the netting. Be outside because of the power play.
Well, and if there's a lot of youth hockey teams.
Clark just slashed Spinozzi, 22.
You know, for all the young coaches out there, if they're watching the Wheeling power play, they don't do anything fancy. They move it quickly and get the puck to the net. And they have two people going for the rebound. They're not necessarily shooting for a goal. They're shooting for a rebound or another shot because they figure, hey, we can outnumber them down low. And that's what happened on the first goal.
It was good to see Shaw come back there playing deep in the slot there to cover that one. Here's Camras. Binkley taking it in deep.
Drive to the net.
Oh, working hard. 1:28 to go in the period.
Get back.
Sidlowski playing some defense. Goes wide.
Good job by Sadlowski covering for Binkley. That was
Camras.
Well, there's a hook.
Well, I guess.
Can't worry about what's not called. Just run them.
Sadlowski. Boom! Shot.
They oh. hit Camras.
Nice play there by Lowney. As Phillips goes back to pick it up, Phillips takes it right up the middle. Taking a look, still some time. Sadlowski with a wrist shot, goes
nice
wide.
Shot.
Yes. Oh, and the net's ajar. That's not too bad for us, though, Doug. We can regain, hopefully
off.
Get this face off. With 39.8 seconds to go. Good job for the Comets to get a face off. See if we can't tie this game up going into the second period. Good shot by Sadlowski, Doug.
Yeah, nice and low.
Wide, but still a good shot.
He was anticipating the goalie to kind of overplay it, and the rebound would have come out right to us, but smart play on his shot.
Phillips out on the point. He was talking it over a little bit with Campagna, if he can get it. Oh, right there in the glove hand.
Good face off, good draw, good shot.
They're going to replace the defense. Binkley, Lowney going out. Lowney going to up, way up in the left wing. Going to try to get it back out to Campagna or to Binkley on the point. And Campagna, oh, just couldn't keep
yeah,
it in.
Won it too hard.
That was on the goaltender. 28 seconds to go. They tip it into the zone. Binkley back after it. In the corner.
Good job.
13 seconds. Oh, we had to hustle. And they're going to call that icing. Oh, boy. A lot can happen when you're under a half a minute to go. You think you got possession of it in the offensive zone. Now with 5.6 seconds to go, it's back in your zone.
And if they win it clean, they can get a good shot. So now everyone's just got to be focused, take care of the defense. Wheeling's got up to 8 shots now.
Zach Lynch, he's... number 10 in the scoring. He got 50 points. He's out of Chicago. And that should do it for period number one. Comets on the short side of a 2-1 score. Doug, not a bad, totally bad period, though.
No, I mean, other than the score, I thought we played very well. We were playing with good intensity, good tempo. And again, it's one of those breaks that always seems to come back to haunt us. We just got to keep playing the way we are. Drive to the net like we are, we're going to get some more goals. 2-1 is not going to be the final score of this game.
Well, we're out shooting them 16-8, but like Doug said, they're still on the short side of a 2-1 score. We'll be back with period number two. Well, I'll start with the second period. Comets down 2-1. 7,400 plus in here tonight. Not too bad for a Sunday afternoon. Those are all paid attendance.
Yeah, now we just got to score some goals.
Yep.
And take care of business against this team.
Well, we definitely got to watch our penalties as we've noted numerous times already that Wheeling is only third in the league in power plays. We got to definitely watch our penalties.
Well, and when we're talking about that, when we say the team takes a good penalty, it means you're preventing the other team from getting a scoring chance and you had to take the penalty to stop it.
Or bringing a guy with you, bringing one with you.
You know, but like Sid's penalty, he was right beside the ref.
Yeah.
He took a good hit, didn't like the hit, and just kind of chopped at his feet and tripped him up, and you're going to get a penalty on that every time.
Yeah, and the referee was like 3 feet away. So a little too obvious. K's in the attacking zone, still have possession.
Yeah, usually Sid's a lot more subtle.
Yeah, usually, yeah. He's been around long enough. Batista just goes behind the net. Shaw back in the corner, controls the puck. Tried to put himself between the player and the puck.
Puts it in deep again. Putting a lot of pressure on him.
Seskin on the boards. Oh, picking it up there is Spinozzi. Seskin back to his defensive partner. Oh, got in a little bit too deep.
Linesman had to duck out of the way.
Got out of the way. I mentioned at the start of the game, we've got two linesmen. Their names are Williams. I would imagine they're brothers, but I don't know. Who knows? Christopher and Trent. So, well, who knows? Keeping it active as Wheeling brings it out.
That's offside.
That's offside, thank you. And as Shasma throws the left arm up in the air to remind the linesman that was offside.
You know, he's just a nice guy like that, just helping them do their job.
Doing whatever he can. Yes, he does.
That does a little bit of everything.
Well, like you said, it's hard to believe he's 36, still playing the game, and I see the passion out there. And
plays it at a high level.
And if it dropped down, the passion, I'm talking about the other night when he had three checks in one shift, although it was in the third period still, but he has that passion. He wants to do better, wants the team to succeed. He comes out there, and he always brings a different aspect of the game when he comes on the ice, and he leads by example. And you don't see that in a guy normally when they're reaching that age. They get one more shift, you know. But like you say, I think he could last another year, maybe two.
Well, he plays the game one way, and that's all out. Like you say, some guys start mailing it in a little bit, but the reason he's been so valuable – both to Allen Americans before he came here, was he's that team leader in the locker room, in the bench.
Well, and he's also played in Europe a few times, a number of years anyway.
Here he goes.
Here he goes right now. He's experienced that, you know. He's been there, done that. He doesn't need to worry about going to Europe or anything like a lot of guys want to, you know, take advantage of that opportunity. Here's Lowney with it, dumps it in.
Well, it's just like Baptista and Sadlowski came back shortly after the start of their season.
Yep.
Because some guys just don't like the style over there.
Yeah, you know, how do you want to be happy? You want to be happy playing your game. Campagna, trying to keep it in. Gets outside, it's one-on-one.
Going up high again.
Showing the old shoulder there. Cody Saul played that well. Now we're going to get as Shasby gets his helmet shoved off or the back.
Giving someone a penalty.
Campagna going to the box. I thought it was a one-on-one, but interference.
I'm sure Shasby was arguing him.
No, that's that dreaded power play we didn't want to see come.
I didn't really see where that.
I didn't either. I missed it totally. I'm sure Otto got it, but I missed it.
Yeah, Gary's getting a little frustrated with the ref and his calls.
Let's see if we can't get a shorthanded one here. Maybe that will be something to pick us up a little bit. Into the corner. Here's Shaw. Just chips it out. That's all right. Here's Batista going after it. Follow him on around. I would not have stopped skating. I would have gone after him. Spinozzi. You know, we picked one up in the face. We're getting a penalty for high sticking. Is he dripping anything? As the referee goes over there to see if he is.
Well, my question is, if the stick bounces up off his stick, it shouldn't be a high stick.
Yep, Comet's getting another penalty. Shasma talking about it.
I'm sure he's asking him, well, it went off someone's stick. And of course, in this day and age, it's, you know, you got to keep your stick under control at all times.
Yep, yep. Clark up in here in the press box the other night with that debacle that we had going on the ice as well. He said, I'm kind of glad I'm not playing tonight. I was kind of upset before. He said, I'm kind of glad I'm not playing in this one.
Well, same thing for Hafner. He was out of the lineup that night. And
yeah.
About 10 minutes in, he's probably thinking, thank goodness I'm not one of the goalies because they weren't getting any help.
No, not at all. Not at all.
It was worse than being in a beer league game.
As the K's get it outside the zone anyway, Binkley does a good job of clearing it.
Big penalty kill here.
Some nosy hanging out by the blue line.
Let's see if we get any makeup calls.
Ooh, nice and off the Saul, off the skate of Saul there that directed behind the net. Ooh, a swing and a miss on that one with out in the front.
On the puck, but he didn't miss when he was chopping their guy.
Well, broken stick by Wheeling.
Yeah, Binkley
sure.
Kind of chopped their stick right in half.
Yeah.
I'm sure the Wheeling players are asking, okay,
yeah,
are you going to call any of those?
Why wasn't that a slice, he's thinking. Those composite sticks, though, are very expensive. They're very strong, but they're kind of like brittle, I understand, that they can get hit like that. They just break in half.
Well, when you get chopped hard enough.
And they go.
You know, I don't care what they're made out of. With some of the chops that we're seeing, you know, and all the GMs can do is look at it and think, oh, that's a couple $100s.
Yes, there it goes.
Even with a deal.
Well, if you've been listening to these games with Doug and I over the last number of years, you'll understand Doug likes to do a lot of that chopping and slicing.
I couldn't fight.
He encourages it. Oh, I wouldn't say
fight.
That. I wouldn't say
oh,
that.
Oh, no, I'll say it.
No,
I'm lucky to catch my breath in a Legends game. Good
Comets.
Job, penalty kill. Just keep them around the outside. Let's see if we can.
Nice deflection into the corner, Doug. I like that.
Get back in position.
Ooh, good.
Yeah, can't get running around. Got to play the triangle.
18 seconds to go in the first penalty. Nice block
nice
there
block
by Binkley.
Yes.
Here's Batista. Nice job. He held on for a moment.
Get a complete change.
That.
One penalty's over. 23 seconds left on the other.
Comets can kill this off. Big plus for them. There we go. Good job.
And they're now getting a penalty.
And the whistle. Looks like there's somewhat of a question there by the Wheeling player. Looks like Trevor Yates going to the box. Ooh, that was a good one, Otto.
But again, Seskon drew that penalty, got the loose puck and cleared it down. And, you know, we just got to keep going. Now we're going to be on a power play here in about 4 seconds. And
oh, yeah. Yeah, Seskin went down pretty hard in the old back. You can't brace yourself. It's a little tough when you're going
when
backwards.
When you don't see it coming, and all of a sudden they take your feet out, and you're going back. Luckily, he didn't hit his head.
Yeah.
You see a lot of bad things come out of that, but now let's just get control of the puck.
Here's Lowney with it into the side. Good effort there.
Campagna kind of reminds me of Barry Scully. There's not a shot that he doesn't like.
Oh, Lowney keeps it in. Oh, I don't know about that.
It was up in the air, but I don't think it came out of the zone.
No, I don't either.
But he's not going to change the calls, so.
But I'd rather see it called, I guess, you know, both ways, though. Yeah, I'd rather see.
I mean, he was very convinced on his call. He made it and moved on, didn't try explaining it, which I like.
Wanted to readjust Shastma there. Shastma do a good job of going after it there. Putting the pressure on. Whew. Lowney doing a good job of dropping right back to the perfect spot. Sadowski in the far side.
Get some speed.
This Shastma. Campagna with it.
Went off their skate. I liked what he was trying to do. Wheeling just kind of lining up across the blue line. It's one of those where we got to just chip it into the zone and outskate them because they're standing still.
Protecting that puck there.
Let's get it set up, move down. Going for a change. Fans are getting a little irritated, but smart play by Lowney's part. Get some fresh legs out.
Here we go. Petroselli with it. Inside the zone, that's what you want to be. Oh!
Oh.
Just out of the reach of Shaw.
Right idea.
Petroselli. There we go. Oh, boy.
Getting some speed.
Outskated Shaw on that one. He wanted Shaw to go with him.
Get the heck out of the way.
Boy, I guess. Right on the line. Nice catch on the far side. Binkley with it. Petroselli out to the point. Come on, let her go. Oh, right in the pads.
Yep, goalie gave up, no rebound. We had Shaw.
Shaw on one side and Batista on the other. Boy, 9-10.
Sure, Shaw's telling him, hey, you need to get out of the way. But we just got to keep going. I mean, we're working hard. We got to just adjust on our power play that when they line up across the blue line, we just need to chip it in and go out, skate them to get to it.
Face off to the right of Jordan Ruby. Clark, nice job there. Trying to scrum it out. And referee right there making that call. So much of the time, the puck is, there's Michael Franke over here to Doug's left.
Well, you just never know what Michael's going to be up to.
Oh, I know, I know. You never know what he's going to do. Get a hot dog, yeah. Thank God they showed up the other night at the right time.
We just got to keep going, get some shots here.
Oh, Michael, he's the character.
Three shots for each team this period so far.
Comets get possession. Oh, nice hanging on to it. Nobody there for the rebound. Well, he kept it in there for a moment. Nice
I think
job
we need a
Krunk.
Chance to get Krunk some more ice time here.
Little interference there. Ah, picking it up there is Cam Brown.
Got to go to the body.
Here's Phillips with it. I wasn't impressed with Phillips when I first saw his numbers coming in here, Doug, but he's sort of like a Lowney. Small in stature, but he seems to handle the puck fairly well.
He does. He works hard.
Couldn't get it through everybody in front there. Nice tip there as Phillips lets it go into the corner, takes the body. Got enough Campagna with it.
Kind of grabbing the guy's head.
Okay, don't stop skating. There you go. Someone get in front. Nobody in front. Oh, right there!
Yeah. Oh, I thought, how did that not go in?
Boy, there's what you want. Far side, Shastma with it. Going off his skates. And they get possession of it, bring it out over the red line. A little behind the play there. As the referee's going to call them
both. Well, I like that he's calling them both.
Yeah.
Their guy's trying to say, well, he should get the penalty because I didn't draw my gloves. Then he's going to go talk. Either you're going to fight or you're not. Sid was ready to fight.
Yep.
Dropped his gloves. Their guy skated away like a coward.
Yep. I don't think that's we've seen the last of that. Jeez.
Well, the guy was chopping at Sid. And Sid, you could tell, I know exactly what he's saying. You want to go?
Oh, yes.
And I'm sure the guy was saying, yeah. And so Sid dropped his glove. Their guy skated away thinking, oh, Sid's just going to get the penalty because he dropped his gloves.
That's a cross. He was in there before for another reason.
Well, with Soul.
Soul,
they
kind of
wrestled around.
Yep.
Heck, if you're going to fight the big guy, why not fight someone a little smaller like Sid?
Yeah.
Unless you know Sid can really throw him and
get go. Yep. Face off outside the Comet bench. There we go to the net. I like that.
And the ref's in the way again.
Here's Lowney with it. Oh.
Good job by Shaw.
Batista deep in the corner. Boy. Doing a good job there, keeping the puck. Shaw. Oh! They freed it up. Here's Batista on the near side. Little holding. And what's the call now?
Goalie's helmet come off or something.
Well, he took it off, but...
Losing
why did he blow the whistle? Even Mike Franke was just, how did that call happen?
Well, he was losing, I think he lost a glove or something.
Boy, you got me on that one. Yeah, because I looked over there, referee's arms up in the air for the whistle, and goaltender's got his mask on. I mean, I don't know why.
Well, he didn't have one of the... Either his catcher's mitt or blocker off, and his stick's off on the side. So,
yeah, a little question.
The goalie wasn't he's not too happy. He's saying a lot to the ref. So, we're not the only team that's not happy with him. So,
no. 4-on-4.
We just got to keep going.
Comets with possession of the puck inside the zone. They lose it. Taken off was Fick. Fick behind the net. Drops it back. Butcher over the line. Trying to get something set up. Oh, nice job. Throwing it on back.
Whatever happened to the days where you could run the goalie?
Yeah. Oh, here we got possession. Oh, he lost it. Nice pull down, no call. Here's Seskon deep. Out to the point. Phillips.
Oh, lost the puck. Pan, you working hard?
Oh, yeah.
Needs a quick change.
Possession. Phillips with it. Petrocelli, Camraz just couldn't get a hold of it as they bring it out on the near side. Nice job. I like how he got a position on that one. It was Clark. Still onside. Camraz.
Here we go. Sidlowski in.
Right in the middle.
We knew that one was going to end.
It's Sean, he's a tough kid.
Oh, boy, he landed good right there. Oh. Old-time hockey, Doug. He's in the...
Well, when you're struggling scoring-wise, Sean's not afraid to throw some punches to get things going.
Just came out of the penalty box, going right back in again. But both
guys were swinging pretty good, but I'd have to say Sean got a good number in.
Oh, yeah. Old-time hockey. You even saw Bobby Hall in the day. You wouldn't want to fight that guy, but even Bobby Hall would drop the gloves. Score the goals and still drop the gloves. And Sean is definitely a competitor. 2-1 Wheeling with 9:20 remaining in period number two.
Got TV timeout. Well, and the thing is, we just got to keep going. I mean, we're getting some chances. We just got to bear down and bury one.
Yeah, we're getting the traffic in front. We just, like you say, we got to bear down and get one.
Because really, we get one, we're going to get a bunch. You know, we just got to get over that first hurdle.
Looks like they're run out of goaltender runners or something.
They're a little short. It looks like short on the interns. When you start seeing that Icy's out there.
Oh, and he gets pushed down. Poor Icy. Well, Comets with still out shooting him 2-1, 22-11 shots on goal. Still getting the opportunities. Just got to capitalize on it. Fucali over there on the door of the Comet bench. Got the Comet hat on and his goaltender blocker on. Oh, boy.
Yet Sid landed. Well, the thing with Sid is he punches with that left hand when he's holding your jersey. He's kind of giving you that little jab, keep you off balance.
Yeah, he does.
Their guy was throwing some pretty good size haymakers, but he wasn't landing
really
any.
Really wasn't connecting very well, yeah.
And when Sid plays physical like that, he gets really into the game, so I'm expecting great things from him for the rest of this game.
Exactly.
We definitely can use him to start scoring some goals.
That's for sure.
They've kind of come at a premium for him this year.
Well, it was nice to see the Comets pick up Clark. He's definitely one to, you know, like Sescon, to show that physical ability to, keep the Comets into a game like this. Here they go, Petroselli, nice shot. Gets a little wide. Oh, right there. Boy, we're having some opportunities. Here's Binkley forcing a play.
Good collision down in the corner.
Shaw
still comes up with the puck.
Here's Petroselli. Keeping it live. Shaw again, nice little body check. He gets hit again and again. See if we can't keep it in the zone. Lowney, he does. Oh, Campagna couldn't control it. Lowney on his knees gets that one off. Campagna, oh, trying to get that shot going. Lowney, far side. Campagna in the corner, deep.
Someone get over there and help him out.
Oh, kept it on the line. Right on the line.
Good job. Got some fresh legs out there.
Wheeling just dumps it out and gets it.
Get some fresh players out on their behalf. Their guys are getting pretty tired.
Yes. Good effort by the Comets. They've got 25 now to 11 on the shots. Picked up a few on that last shift. Here's Ciro in deep. Got deflected. Bringing it out there is Hirano. He gets picked off. Here's Camras. Ooh, nice move there. Ah, can't keep control of it.
Good tempo by both teams. Oh, Saul lost an edge.
Yes, he did.
Jeez. Hafner was kind of screened by our other defenseman, but it all started with Saul losing an edge. Again, we have great pressure and everything on them. Then they come down and they score a goal. You know, that's a little heartbreaking.
I'm not sure how ready Hafner was for that one.
Well, he had a lot of travel. He had Lowney was in front and their player, so he couldn't really see where the puck was at. He was kind of guessing.
Robbie Hall getting credit for that goal. That's his first goal of the season. He's a defenseman. Well, Comets got to just pick it up again. Chasma just dumps it in. Getting run over there a little bit by Trevor Yates.
Yeah, all we need to worry about is getting one goal.
Yep.
Try not doing too much.
Yeah, let the puck do the work, as they say. That was a nice little move. On the near side, here's Seskon. Oh, there's an opportunity. We got to take advantage of that one.
Going down to Hafner.
Oh.
And he almost lost it.
Yeah. Face off to his left, I believe.
But again, I mean, we played a number of great shifts. We had one mistake where Cody lost an edge, and they went in and scored. I think that was their first shot in about 8 minutes.
Oh, yeah.
You know, it's not how many shots you have, it's how many go in.
You know, yeah, we've had the shots, 25 so far with 6:31 remaining in the period. Comes down 3-1.
You know, they've got one goal every four shots. We've got one goal every 25 shots.
And he hit behind. Pitch Petrocelli. He stops skating. Oh, right there on the short side.
Yep, just needed someone to have their stick on the ice right by the post.
Batista getting jumped there. Shaw doing a good job of getting physical in there. Behind the net. Around the far side, no one home.
Yeah, but Batista thought the defenseman was out there, but Binkley had started to jump in.
Binkley gets it back.
Here we
go. Nice. Kamarask with a nice shot. Is not able to penetrate the goaltender. Oh, my gosh. He just couldn't get the handle on that. Was Lowney. Nice job by Chasma. On the near side is Lowney on the boards. Nice job. How did he ever get it to Camras right there? I don't know about that one. Here's Shaw as Saul going after it. Clark on the near side. Campagna. Just tried to do a nice little one off the boards. Couldn't get successful on that one. It's going to be a penalty on Wheeling. As Combs is going to try to get.
Yeah, that was a stupid penalty on his part.
Oh, right in front of the goal, right in front of the referee. Come on, boys. Let's see if we can't get this thing.
Oh.
Yeah, it looks like Brian Diffley going to the box.
Well, big power play for us. We need to get some chances. Wheeling has done a good job on keeping us away from getting a good shot. We've got to take a page out of their book of quick passes and a shot. I mean, our only goal was right off a faceoff, got out to the D, got someone in front of the goalie, and just shot. Lowney shot it from the point.
Well, we can't wait till the third period. We got 4:41 remaining here. We got this opportunity to cut the deficit down by one. Right now it's 3-1 Wheeling. And they get a hold of it. And they just hit the linesman.
Linesman, that one hurts.
Yeah. Looks like he's okay. That was Christopher Williams. Oh,
nice
oh.
shot.
Phillips on the far side to Binkley. Can't keep it in? Yes, we do keep it in. Shaw behind the net. Oh, right there. Ah. Boy, if Doug, if Petrucelli could have kept that, got that shot off right away. You know, it held it just for that one half a second.
And just long enough for the goalie to get back in position
yep.
just to get enough of it. But again, the thing I liked was we're moving the puck. We're getting good shots. Schaub doing a great job behind the net, driving to the front of the net.
Well, you know, the way he handled behind the net, he brought everybody to the front of the net. I almost had too much traffic in there that if we did score, it might have been disallowed with maybe a goaltender interference
well,
or whatever.
Well, Wheeling has done a really good job of really collapsing down. They don't know where the puck's at, but they just start chopping and punching to knock Comet players loose.
Yeah, as Petrucelli caught one in the face there just a moment ago.
Yeah, he gave a couple back.
Maybe he gave him back, yeah. Sadowski out. He's lined up against
Spinozzi.
Good little the movie Slapshot going on right now. Chasma caught one in the face. Broke a stick. Still kept the puck in the zone. Jeez. Oh, and we got a possession.
Wow.
He was able to go get a stick on the bench and still keep the puck in the...
Oh. That's the shot we wanted.
Yeah.
Oh, lost the puck.
Kept it on the line. How about that? Whoa, boy. Here we go.
Then lost it again.
Here's Lowney with it. Going after it anyway.
Here
we
go. Go to the body. Let's start skating. There we go.
On the near side. Shasma still out there. Oh, it goes too wide.
Went high.
Oh, boy. It's down one. Boy, 1-2-3. Comet's down. 4-1. Little mistake at the blue line, and
they went down odd man and just kind of tic-tac-toe. Hafner had no chance. It's one of those when things go bad, they go really bad.
Yep. Got ourselves caught really in deep there. And
well, when you start kind of pressing and going for things, you got to take chances, and that's what happens. And now we just have to try getting a goal here.
Well, there's no doubt we can come back. Just Otto says we got them right where we want them. Yeah, that's Lynch's 15th goal this
season. There's a hooking penalty.
Yeah, Otto says, do we want it?
It's one of those, can we decline?
Yeah.
Like football, man. But the thing again, two of their goals, we've had defensemen lose an edge and go down and in an area that you can't afford to for it to happen. So now all we got to do is if we get a goal here before the end of the period, we can get that momentum going in instead of thinking, oh, crap,
yep.
we've been playing well. Now it's 4-1.
Yeah, we're still out shooting 28-13. It's just very disappointing.
Yeah, their last two shots they've scored on.
Yeah.
And very high percentage shots that they've got. So, but we just got to keep grinding away.
Well, you thought our luck had changed there with Shasma. Broke a stick, and we still were able to keep the puck inside the offensive zone.
And we had a couple chances.
Had
but
some chances, but yeah.
You know, we just got to keep working.
Here's Lowney with it, right up the middle. Dropping it back. Camras. Here's Sadowski. Digging at it. Around to the far side. Oh, boy. Hell, that's the way things are going.
It is.
The way things are going.
You know, again, we got third period. Wheeling is playing the perfect road game. They've got what they want. They got the lead. They're not doing anything fancy.
Petroselli, near side. Batista just backhands it in. That's going to be an icing. No, they're man the box.
They're shorthanded.
1:34 to go in the period.
But these last two goals have definitely taken the air out of the building.
See, I'm not a big favor of that drop back because we've got such little time. I thought he could dump it in and go after that. Oh. Shaw bounces over his stick.
Here we go.
1 minute to go in the period. Shaw with it.
1 minute in the period.
Out to the point. Nice wrist shot by Sidlowski. Or that was Petroselli from the point. That was Phillips, I'm sorry. Phillips with it.
Started with P.
As P, yep. Here's Saul with it on the blue, on the red line. Boy, colorblind. They dump it in.
Guys smartly stayed on the bench.
Under a half a minute. Clark. Nice move there. Here's Kronk, wrist shot. Boy, he's going for that far corner. And Saul. 8 seconds to go. Two seconds. One. Well, that'll do it for period number two. Comets out shooting Wheeling 28-13, but
they got four goals.
Unfortunately, they're down 4-1.
And again, only one goal tonight, I think we could safely blame on the goaltending. The other three, he hasn't had any chance on them.
No.
You know, but again, when you're defensively, when you're giving up one goal every three shots, you're usually not going to have good results.
Well, we got 20 minutes to go. Let's see if we can't turn it around a little bit. Comets down 4-1. Period number three coming up.
All right, hockey fans, tonight, Three Rivers Federal Credit Union would like to showcase a local performance from the community. Please give a warm Comet welcome to Spree Color Guard and Twirling Team under the direction of Twirling Coach Judy Kloppenstein, Color Guard Director of Flag and Choreography Robert Cortez, and Tech Directors Haley Vanderweel and Beth Perkins.
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. I'm feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. Get off! Let's do it.
tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. Tonight's the night.
Hey!
Let's live it up.
Let's live it up.
I got my money.
Hey!
Let's spin it up.
Let's spin it up.
Go out and smash it.
Smash it.
Like on my car.
Like on my car.
Jump out that sofa.
Come on.
Let's get, get. Oh! Fill up my cup.
Drink.
Mazel tov. Look at her dancing.
Move it, move
just
it.
Take it. Oh! Let's paint the town.
Paint the town.
We'll shut it down.
Shut it down.
Let's burn the roof. And then we'll do it again.
Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it.
Let's do it.
And do it.
And do it.
Let's live it up.
And do it.
Do it.
And do it.
Do it.
And do it.
Do it.
Do it.
Do it.
Let's do it.
Do it.
Let's do it.
Do it.
Let's do it.
Do it.
Do it.
Do it.
Here we come. Here we go. We gotta rock.
Rock. Rock. Rock. Rock.
Easy come. Easy go. Now we on top.
Top. Top. Top. Top.
Feel the shot. Body rock. Rockin' don't stop.
Stop. Stop. Stop. Stop.
Round and round. Up and down. Around the clock.
Rock. 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 Rock.
Monday. Tuesday. Wednesday. And Thursday.
Do it.
Friday. Saturday. You know what we say, say. Party every day, pop, pop, pop. Party every day. And I'm feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. I'm feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be.
All right, Hockey Canadians, let's give another round of applause for the Spree Color Guard and Swirling Team. If you have a group that you would like to be a part of the Three Rivers Federal Credit Union Community Showcase, please email info@diamonds.com. One more time, a big Comet welcome.
And we're back with start of a third period. Comets down 4-1. As a former player at this little higher level than this, Doug, it's nice to know that what you and I are thinking, Dave Franke, the general manager of the Comets, is thinking too, pretty much on the same line.
Well, you know, from watching what's going on, it's pretty obvious of what some of the issues are. And, you know, right now we put some pressure on, they come down, they score. And again, all we have to do is get, if we get one goal, we can start getting some momentum.
Good hit there behind the net as Petrucelli goes after it. That was a crazy bounce. We did recover it, though. See, I'm just not a big one on that one, you know. He's got it in the neutral zone.
I'm with you there.
Just dump it in. Go after it. I mean, you should have the step on these guys.
Here we go. Get some pressure. Nice shot, right, but right into the belly.
Right at him. I'd rather see it go off the post or crossbar. Faceoff nonetheless to the left of a goaltender, Jordan Ruby.
But when you're struggling, stuff like that happens. You know, you don't mean to do it. You know, and one thing people will look at team as we're struggling and they say, oh, they're playing like this and they're not doing this. The guys have a lot of pride. They don't want to be playing bad. It's just we're in a rut, and different guys are making mental mistakes more than anything that's costing us goals.
And believe me, we talked to David about guys being called up the America League and stuff, and he's upset a lot like we are. They're not even playing up there, and they're making the big money. They're, you know, obviously a little bit bigger money than this, but they're not playing. And
as a player, you're not going to complain about it because – like they said, you complain, you know, you'll never get back.
Yeah.
You know, so you kind of have to be that good soldier of not saying anything. You want to play.
Here, Lonnie behind the net as he gets out. Big long passes.
Going to the body.
Here we go. We pick it up. Now we're inside the zone. And that goes up in the netting. Another
taking a little too long to get the shot off. And, you know, it's just like David talks about, you know, and we've talked about it, that when the guys get called up, you know, there's so much more politics that go on behind the scenes on a player getting called up. Maine wants the rights to Martineau. He's in Laval, you know, and so all of a sudden there's deals going on that, you know, can really hurt us, and we need one or two of the players back here because Wah really makes a difference on our team, both in energy, and he makes better the players around him better.
That's right. Now, David was talking about there's a lot of things that we can't pass on or we don't want to pass on, but big thing is the management cares about what's going on here, and they do whatever they can to get the best players available as possible. And how Vegas just doesn't have that much depth in at this level.
Well, and like, you know,
nice.
In the next year or so, there we go. Nice goal.
There we go. That's Clark.
Coming out of the corner, driving to the front.
And he's got people in front, too. He's got traffic.
Just a quick wrist shot. Now we can get going. You know, people ask, you know, why hasn't Vegas put more players down here? And like David said, you know, they're thin up in Chicago because they don't have that many players in their system. They have more coming. They got a bunch of their draft picks are still in juniors.
Right.
So they're going to be coming up. So there's going to be more players available next year, but doesn't do us any good now. The old horn got stuck.
Got stuck. Hasn't been used that much. It got stuck. Yeah, good
but
shot
a nice,
for Clark.
Nice goal. And again, drove to the net and shot the puck.
He brought people to the net when he did that. Nice and off the boards. Again, Comets need to keep possession of the puck. Here we are inside. Nice job
nice
by
shot.
Shaw. Quick shot. Good shot. Comets still putting the pressure on, keeping it lively out in front. Phillips
good hit.
Good hit by Shaw again. Batista after it. That gets out of the rink. They're saying they got deflected or not. I don't know. Looks like there'll be a penalty here. Oh, wait a minute.
Yeah, they're getting a penalty.
Yeah, they are getting a penalty. Delay a game. Face off deep inside the Wheeling zone. This is a great opportunity, Doug. We could get one here. We're back in the game. We're back in the game.
Very important that we don't get too fancy. Just get the puck to the net. Wheeling has a lot of guys that can scoot, so we don't want to be playing around with it out at the blue line, where if a guy falls like we've had two goals against.
Sadlowski and
Sadlowski is due.
Lowney out front. I say out front, no, the top of the blue line anyway. Wanting to feed it to Sean. He's got the puck. Oh, right there's for rebound. Can't keep it in.
Companion.
Lowney comes back.
He's got to jump on that rebound a little bit quicker.
Here's Sadlowski, far side. Companion on the far side.
Move it in deep.
Oh, Sadlowski has to go into it. Can we keep it in? Yes. Oh.
The guy, oh. Gotta look.
That
here we go. Got some speed.
Pass. Oh.
Trying to stick handle too much. Got to help out our goaltender.
I don't like that. I'd like to see it go out towards the blue line a little bit better. Here's on the near side to Binkley. Shaw with it. Oh, I thought he was going to draw a penalty there. Shaw to the front. Gosh, you got to get rid of it.
Well, I thought should have been a penalty on.
Petruccelli got pulled down.
Good job.
Kept alive. Binkley with it. Far side. Phillips deep into the corner. Gets pulled down, no call. And again, comes all the way back down.
Got to get a change out there.
6 seconds to go in the penalty.
But we had some good chances.
Zero on the near side. This away just barely gets it into the zone.
Yeah, their guy was coming hard out of the penalty box. Almost a suicide pass to him.
Looks like it's going to be on the net. Cody Saul loses it. This way just dumps it in, a far corner for him, near for us. Here's Ciro behind the net. Saul with a big blast.
Went wide.
Clark trying to control it.
Someone help him out.
Sidlowski trying to.
Right idea.
Oh, we weren't able to catch it. Oh, whoa, that was off. I thought it was offside.
Didn't even look like it was close.
Yeah. Deep sigh there. Far side. Picking it up. Campagna.
Good shot low.
Picking it up there is Hirano.
Yeah, I'd fall down too.
Yeah.
Seskon about to drill me.
Out to the point. Gets deflected into the corner. Thomas with 35 shots. Oh, my gosh.
They get one shot this period, they score.
Well, that's kind of the way it's been going tonight.
It really has. I mean, we play so well, so hard for so many shifts. Make one mistake.
Get on the board. Get on the board. Make it somewhat respectable now. Thank you, Otto. Looks like that's going to go to Butcher, his 10th of the season. Second of the game.
Let's see. Put it out to 21.
Oh, they're going to give it to Lynch.
Yeah, Lynch got it. Butcher passed it out. But again, no one picked up Lynch, and he went in home free. Again, you know.
3-goal deficit.
One goal every three shots. You know, this is where you, you know, and we put a lot of pressure on our goalies. But we need that key save.
A lot of action going on in front of the net with Winston Daychief and Lowney. He reaches for that one. Here's Daychief. Nice shot. Good save there.
Big save by Hafner.
35-16 as we're 17 now. Still out shooting the opposition. Just not getting the bounces.
Well, you make your bounces. You know.
Trying to think of anything excuse to say.
Well, you're. I appreciate you trying to be positive. I mean, we've done a lot of good things in the game, but the result is we give up that goal. I mean,
yeah.
we start getting the momentum back, then we have the good chance. We don't bury it. Then they come down, they get one chance, and they put it in the net. And I mean, the last few games, that's the way it's been.
Yeah. I think plenty of time yet if we can just start making it pay off. Clark, far side. Cody Saul with it. Dumping it in. And they're going to call it icing. Come on. That was right.
It
right
seemed
there.
Like it was close enough, but, you know.
Yep.
When it goes bad, it goes really bad.
Face off to the left of Lucas
Hafner.
Nine
other times on a play like that, they just wave it off.
And yeah, they wave it off.
But again, we started getting some life back into the crowd that we had, and you know, gave up that one goal, and it was like literally their first shot of the period.
Yep. Then they stop us at neutral zone. Camras with it.
Their player's got to get off the ice. Lost his helmet.
Backhand goes wide. It's so risky right there as a defenseman. That
yeah, you got to make sure you keep your body between them and the net.
That's it. Good job by Camras. He gets his own rebound. Good job by Phillips. Kept it in, but they gained possession of it. Campagna on the far side, backed to the defense. Well, Phillips back to pick it up. See if we can't get something going here as they pick it up.
Yeah, and Wheeling is just trying to keep it really boring. Just dump the puck in.
Well, Binkley trying to make him pay for that one. Shastma with it now. The captain brings it back. Passes
in the change
to Binkley. Blinky right in the middle. Oh. 10:20 to go in period three. Comets down by three again. And that's going to be offside.
Well, this coming week we have a chance. We got three home games and just to get back on track.
Batista passes it off, gets it back to the near side. Here's Shaw, loses it off the end of his stick. Batista, far side. Batista gets it back, goes out to the point. Clark, down the middle to Saul. Take that shot, gets deflected up into the netting. Face off inside the Wheeling zone. It's a TV timeout with 9:37 to go.
You know, and it's just like we're going to be in a playoff mode for the rest of the season. Every point is valuable. We just got to come up with a lineup of what we have and our goaltenders to put someone in and just ride that goaltender till he's not doing the job.
Well, think of the guys that we had now back up with Chicago again. Martineau, Waugh. There's three guys
Weiss,
right there.
And Weiss, then get yeah. Hodgman back. I mean, Hodgman had been having a great season, point-wise and everything. And hopefully his hand's finally healing that we can get him back here shortly. Because, I mean, we get one or two of those guys back, it changes how our lines are played.
Oh,
and
yeah.
It can change the whole attitude of the team because you got a couple guys that will be pretty fresh and just keep going.
Yeah, their whole attitude would definitely change when they see that. Well, they had Clark up on the big screen, one of its fights. Very physical player, loves to play the game physically.
Yeah, he's not afraid.
Good reason we got him to come in here and wear the old orange and black.
Well, and he's been a solid addition on our defense, and especially first off, we got to make the playoffs, but he's the type of player that you need in the playoffs.
Out to the point, can't keep it in.
Wanted fairly clean. It didn't just quite go the direction we wanted it.
A little deflection to get into the zone. Well, we've been tipping it into the zone. I think we've almost got to get possession of it, get into the zone.
Well, they're playing very tight defense.
Oh, I thought that was going to be the opportunity we needed. Here's Sadowski with it. You got one in front of the net trying to get a position. It's Shasma. There we go. And it's Sean Sadowski. Yes, yes, yes.
Pulling the monkey off his back and stabbing
it. Did you see that? That's what he was doing. I hope Otto picked that up. That was good.
Lowney got the puck to the net. Sid was right there. Rebound was right there, and he buried it. So now we got it down to 5-3. We just got to keep going.
And, Sean, if you saw Otto had it, couldn't tell if or not, but he was reaching back there to get that monkey off his back. A good observation, Doug.
Yep. And, took it off his back and stabbed it with his stick.
There we needed. We needed that. And that looks like that's where we got a score from. Nice wrist shot out in front.
And Krunk battling in front.
Now he's got to be physical, but he's got to be smart here, Doug.
Well, and that's one thing I like about Krunk. He's not going to do anything stupid, and especially when he knows we need a goal, he's going to make his presence known. And just like there, but he's the type of player. He reminds me, in a sense, of Jasper, John Hillworth. He was a player, tough as nails, someone you didn't want to make mad because he could totally destroy a person.
Yep.
But he played it the way he would take a hit. If it was clean, he was fine. If it was dirty, then you paid for it.
Yes. If not, then a little bit later. Good observation there. Kept it in the zone for a moment anyhow. But I like the activity they had in front of the Comet, in front of the Wheeling net.
There we go.
They keep it action there. Batista deep in behind the goal.
Petruzzelli fighting for it.
Batista is able to get possession of it. Out to the point, Binkley. Boy, that was a nice shot.
Off the side of the net.
Kept it going. Comets get it back.
There we go. Let's get some fresh legs out there.
Petruzzelli. You're right there, Doug. Batista with it. And it's Binkley putting the pressure on. Oh, not able to keep it in there.
Yep. That's when you needed someone else to help them.
Yep. They're making the change. Here's Phillips.
Nice play.
Pass. Oh, how about that?
There we go.
And it looks like Shasma puts us down only by one. Comets 5, the Wheeling 5, Comets 4.
Looked like a shot kind of got deflected by their defenseman's stick just enough where their goalie couldn't grab it. But again, Phillips made the play coming up the ice, moved the puck. Shasma just threw the puck at the net.
Yeah.
Coming across the blue line.
And I was just going to make the comment that I like to have the fact, have possession of it going into the blue, going over the blue line into the attacking zone. Comets back in this game, I'll tell you.
Wheeling taking their time out.
They're probably a very smart decision there.
To try regrouping.
Plenty of time, Doug. 7:18 remaining in the period. Comets come back with 5-4. And who better to score that goal than Jamie Shasma, the captain?
Well, there's
two guys right there. The last two goals, very well deserved. Of two players.
That's the players that we need to be leading us. They're our top players, our highest paid players, but they're the leaders of our team. Like Sid, with pulling the monkey off his back, he's been struggling scoring-wise, and especially the last 10 games. But he's trying to lead in every other way, and tonight he was able to get a goal to start pulling us closer.
Well, Hafner, I'll tell you what, you got to put the pressure on him now. He's got to be strong in this goal the last
we need some saves.
7:18. We got to have some saves. They're gone. Wheeling's definitely going to come back at the effort anyway, and his soul just dumps it in. Kamras going after it. Here's Krunk trying to put some pressure on him. Here's Clark. Nice move there. out in front. Soul with it. Wrist shot.
Oh.
Oh. Comets in possession. Camaras. Krunk was right there in front, too.
Good job on his part.
A little interference, no call. Oh. I didn't want to touch it. As Batista comes back the goal line, picking it up. 6:34 to go in the period.
Here we go, got some speed.
Shaw, nice move inside the line. Out to the point, can Phillips keep it in? He does. Oh. Right out to the point. And they're gonna blow the whistle, why? Still haven't seen any reason. I see the arm going out, but what's
man in the crease?
The call?
Calling man in the crease.
Yeah. Liam Sewell, the referee, talking it over with the goaltender Ruby.
But we got good pressure. We just got to keep going. We're almost at 40 shots. They're still at 17. They haven't had a shot for the last 5-6 minutes.
Here's Batista, gets it back to the defense. It's all right, Petrucelli backhands it into the zone. Get possession of it, control that puck, boys. Oh boy, right across the net. Right across the goal crease. Control it, control it, there we go. All the way behind the net. Make him hold on to it. That's right. Had one Comet player right in front.
Yeah. I think it was Petrucelli.
Like Petrucelli. Yep.
You know, we got Wheeling on their heels. We just got to get this thing tied up.
I was...
very important we get some points.
I was getting deeply apologetic here that the Comets come back and scored two very hardly earned. Sadowski getting the faceoff.
Well, they worked hard and they're starting to put the puck right at the net, so good things happen.
Now to the point, Binkley. Oh, it's going to get deflected up in the netting. Should be inside.
Just got to get that shot off a little quicker because he's got the shot that we want.
I'd like to see it from right there at the hash mark, so that's where I'd like to see that shot.
Now we got Capania in there for the faceoff with Sid back for the one-timer.
The pressure on him. Oh, Chasma got it out, and Sidlowski couldn't hang on to it.
Sid read the play right.
Here's Sidlowski with a nice job. Reaches, make a big reach there. Lowney gets it tipped.
Big save. Big save.
Hip. There you go. Good. Oh, they're going to call that. Come on. Binkley going to go to the box. I thought that was pretty much just a follow through as their player got aggressive. Check.
Yeah, that was a weak call.
Well, Comets going to kill this one off by being very aggressive, Doug. With 5 minutes to go, they got to tie this game up.
I thought they were giving it for roughing or a cross-check.
Yeah.
Okay, well, 5:05, shorthanded goal.
We're due for one. .505 remaining in the period. 39-17 on the shots. Comets lead that.
Got to get it out.
Wow, just about had Hafner going the other way. Right, activity, keeping it to the outside. Out to the point.
Very big penalty kill here for us.
Here we go. Here's Batista with it. He's got Petrucelli with him.
Need a change.
Petrucelli goes after it.
Or draw them into a penalty.
Put the pressure on him. And he goes off. Don't want to get
too
many men.
Down to a minute seven.
Oh,
there we go. Right into the gut. Needed that save.
Yep. 39 to 18 on the shots. 1 minute even going in the penalty to Binkley. Comets have had a lot of tie games in the last month.
Just got to keep going. Got to get that last goal.
Lowney behind the net. Shaw just goes off the boards. Let's Wheeling go back to.
Less than a minute left on the power play.
Bring it out. Picking it up is Hirano.
4 minutes left in the game.
Nice poke check. Shastma, nice move there. Shaw, what a goal!
Nice
shorthanded goal.
Set up by Shastma, but
what a
nice
great
shot.
Play. Huh?
Heavy shot right down on the ice. Goalie got a piece of it through the five hole. Big goal.
3:41 remaining, and Shaw gets a great goal. Great handling the puck, though, by Shastma just outside the blue line.
Got it across and just fed it right to him where he could take it in stride. 35 seconds left in the power play. Just got to finish him off. Caught the goalie five hole. Goalie was guessing he was going to go high, and he put it right on the ice.
Yeah, good for Shaw.
Well, he'd been due.
Yes.
You know, he'd been getting a lot of good scoring chances and hit the post the other night.
Shorthanded. Let's be strong here. Be smart. 23 seconds to go. And it goes off the referee or the linesman.
That linesman's taking a beating tonight. Getting hit twice by the puck, a couple times by players.
Boy, Batista was definitely getting on that position there. Petrucelli, one-handed, brings it around. Another one-handed.
Even strength.
Ah, Shaw couldn't get a hold of it. 2:54
to go in the
period. Now they
got guys flying in. Here we go.
Oh, God, they're going the wrong way. Nice hit. Oh, hello, goodbye. Who was that, Petrucelli?
Shaw.
Was it Shaw?
Oh, off the post by Sadlowski.
And.
Their guy got ran over by Shaw.
Were you able to get that hit? Way to go, Otto. Thank you.
Any other game, they would have called it because it was a shoulder to the head.
Yeah.
But he just got.
And there he's complaining right now, I'm sure.
Well, I don't think the ref really seen it, but he just seen the guy get hit.
Yeah, he is. He's talking about it. Lynch didn't like that too well.
Well, I guess Shaw did kind of come up with his elbow watching the replay.
Comets tie it up, 5-5. Again, great play and last goal by Shastma.
You can just see the confidence back in Sid with getting that goal.
And it draws, doesn't it? Rest of the team draws off that.
It sure does. Got to get back, guys.
On the near side, picking it up. They're inside the zone. Oh, gosh. Nice play. Just out of the reach of Clark.
Clark's got to get back. Our defense are taking too many chances offside.
Thank you.
Oh,
Oh, 150 to go in the period.
Well, these people have seen a little bit of everything.
Jeez. I'm sure there's a few people that gone out to the parking lot there early in the third period and might be trying to get their find their ticket again, get back inside again.
But a minute 50, we just got to keep going. We're getting some good chances. Sid hit the post. And you can just see his confidence rise.
Everybody else. There we go, inside the line. One-handed. Crunk in there taking the body. As they lose possession, here's Lowney back after it. Camras. Oh, goes to the net. Not sure why the whistle's blown.
Well, the goalie lost his glove or whatever.
Is that reason for it?
I think if they lose any of their equipment.
Any of their equipment. Okay.
Not just their helmet, but any of their equipment.
I thought it was just the helmet.
I thought it was rather interesting that after he got run over and their guy's kind of on top of cameras, Crunk just kind of goes over there, stands there, nothing happens. You know, they're whining that they should be running the goalie, but he's trying, goalie kind of
embellished that
embellished
a little bit.
Embellished it.
Yeah. Face off the outside,
though.
I mean,
Camaras was trying to avoid him with the way he was pushed by their guy. Their goalie kind of exaggerates
a little bit. Yes, he did.
Let's get one more on him and watch him flip out.
Oh, yeah.
Because goalies are unique.
Oh, yes.
They're their own breed.
Yes, they are. And that's going to be inside as it gets tipped out.
Yeah, went off the glass and out. Minute 8, big face-off.
Wheeling with a big lead here. Comets came back, gaining that confidence. They got to pull this one out tonight.
Yeah, these are big points, especially with the team right behind us. We got them on their heels. We just got to keep going.
Big goals by Sadlowski and Shaw. There we got it.
Good job by Shaw. He got beat by their winger.
They're going to call that icing. Good, whoa. I like that. Yeah.
We'll take the call, but I thought it was rather weak. But
I do too. Face off the far side to the right of Jordan Ruby.
But that's one thing with these linesmen. They don't hesitate when they're making a call, whether we agree with it or not. They're sticking to it, and that's it. But you can really see Wheeling's on their heels.
Yes, they are.
They're just trying to survive this for 58 seconds to guarantee themselves a point.
And they get possession of it. Phelps on the far side.
Good body position. Can't forget who's Jasper in front of the net.
Definitely going after him. Deep in the corner is Brown. Oh. Whoa.
Big save. That's what we needed out of our goaltender.
Oh, boy.
Come up with that save when things are kind of bouncing around.
Yep. It was... very worried about that. Goaltender's definitely have to stand on his head there.
Well, you want your goalie to come up with a save when you've made a mistake or got out of position. And so far they've had, you know, 5 goals on 19 shots, so the save percentage isn't that great.
Yeah.
Regardless what the reason for the goals are, a lot of people have made mistakes on them.
Wheeling picks it up. You just dump it in. Batista with it. Around to the far side to Shaw. And he loses it. And they gain possession of it. Nice deflection. Went off
took
of Clark's skate.
Hit up high.
7 seconds to go. 5, 3, 2.
Clark kind of going in for a little extra
getting
shot.
The last contact there of regulation. 1.3
seconds.
Faceoff
coming outside is the way the officials are pointing. So the puck must have went up into the net.
Well, Doug, looks like overtime. I can't help but think we
out of the last six games or seven games, this will be overtime number six.
Amazing.
They had five in a row.
Well,
you know, but we'll take it. We'll take the point. I mean, it was hard fought to get back into this game.
Yeah.
Give the guys credit for not giving up.
Exactly.
Because as well as we were playing, we're giving up those goals where they go back to the two-goal lead. And then guys just kept coming. And really it just came down to we started scoring on some of our chances. And who was behind it? Shastma and Sadlowski, leaders on our team, and Shaw. You know, that's why they brought Shaw in, was to be that goal scorer.
Well, like we said earlier there with Sadlowski and Shaw both getting those goals, and then Shastma, I mean,
what looked like a very harmless shot. And a lot of, just like Lowney's goal at the start of the game, looks like a harmless shot, but as Gretzky always said, you never score on 100% of the shots you never take or never put on the net. You know, if you put it on the net, there's always a chance for it to go in.
Well, this will be it, 3-on-3. I must admit, I am kind of a hockey purist. I miss the red line being taken out. I don't really enjoy less players on the ice for overtime, but it is exciting. I'd still rather see 5-on-5, but that's the way it is, and that's what we're going to have to work with. But Comets did a great job out east, I should say, in Newfoundland, going to overtime all three games and didn't do too poorly with a very highly ranked team. Let's see if they can't do something here. We got Batista with it. They're inside the zone. And Petruselli going right to the net.
Yep. Well, a lot of times you see in overtime where a team will have a good scoring chance. If they don't score, it goes down the other way and the other team has the odd man rush and ends the game. But the thing I like about that, Comets came out, we're going hard, and it's like, we want to end this quick.
Well, Sadlowski out there with Batista. Batista working hard, kicks it with his skate.
Oh, just lost the puck.
Sean Sadlowski playing a little defense. Oh, gets off the stick.
Just can't lose. Everyone, they practice this all the time, 3-on-3. Small area games, and you just don't want to lose your person.
They replace one player as Butcher comes out. He's got one goal in the game.
Comets make a change.
Got Shaw out there, Butcher out there too. Lowney. Lowney with it. Fans not liking that too well. I'm not sure. Nice job by Shaw.
Up into the netting. Gives Sid a chance to get off. Get some fresh legs out there. Now we're playing for that extra point.
Now Phillips came out, but it being replaced by Binkley.
We got Shastma, Binkley. Is that Petruselli?
Petruselli, I think, yep. Dan Fick on defense for Wheeling.
Get the puck over to Petruselli and let him go. Hopefully Shastma can just put it straight forward onto Petrozelli's side.
Goes wide. Vic with it. Tries to keep it in the zone. Oh, they're going to call a penalty. Oh, for crying out loud.
Wow. I could see if it was a scoring chance or whatever, but.
Big time offside. Very poor decision there. So now it'll be a 4-3, right, Doug?
Are they calling it on the goalie?
I thought it was Binkley, but. Seskon asking the referee what the story is. Jeez. So now it's 4-3.
Now we got to survive another power play.
Out to the point.
Let's see if we get an even up call.
I wouldn't put too much on it.
Yep, there we go.
Jeez. What a joke.
It is. Look, there guys are trying to figure out, like, okay. That's got to be the weakest hooking penalty I've seen, but, you know, you see it all the time. Because the ref didn't want it to end up being anything to do with his call.
That way they go back 3-on-3 then?
Yes. Oh, they gave him a slash. It was a hook. But of course, Binkley's penalty was more of a roughing than a slash. And well, we've seen a little bit of everything.
Yes,
good, bad, and the ugly.
Yes, we have. Now, wait a minute. Giving them more time, too. Get off the ice.
Never dull.
Yes, sir. Oh.
Good try. Now, got to get back. A lot of chopping going on out there.
Offside. Nice move. Shaw.
Oh, he had him beat the first time.
Can we keep it in? Yeah. Far side. Oh, he hit the skids there, didn't he?
Woo.
Campagna did a good job. Oh, they didn't call that. How terrible.
Didn't see it.
Nice slice against to Binkley. Nice job by Binkley.
Binkley.
Sidlowski, oh, what a wrist shot.
That was the shot we wanted.
Sean Sidlowski on the point.
One-handed
pass. Or shot, I should say.
Oh, be careful, boys.
Boy, Binkley picked the pocket.
Get some fresh legs out there.
Petrozelli going off.
We're on power play.
Oh,
A little high and wide.
Yeah, a little high and wide there. Phillips back to pick
it up.
It's going to
be 4-on-4 here because their guy will be coming out of the box.
Camras, pass it off.
Oh,
that was
a play.
That was it. Thank you.
Good play.
Get picked it up is Hall. Hall with it off the boards. Got another minute.
Got Shastman get going off, get some fresh legs. New defenseman. They're making one last rush. Shot can be
29 seconds. Oh! No call! Unbelievable. Goes over the top of Shaw. Just go at him. No hook or nothing. Boy, good shot by Petroselli.
Go to a shootout here.
-47 Oh, my gosh. Boy, the referee put the whistle away about halfway through that one, didn't he? Wow.
You pretty much had to cut someone's head off before he's going to call
something. I thought Shaw going to lose his there on the near side here right in front of
yeah,
right
it was a flying head tackle, but now we're in a shootout. Now it's our chance to get the extra point. We'll either stay 1 point up on them or be even in the standings.
Yep.
But we get this extra point, we can end up 500 for the week, which is very important.
Come on, JC, let's go.
There we
right.
go.
Five hole, yep.
Big start.
Yes.
Now big play on Havner. Last time we had a shootout, he had a little trouble on it. This first shooter, the key. He stops this guy. The momentum just keeps going.
This is a Japanese player, Hirano. He's got 14 goals so far this season. Hit the post, I believe.
No goal.
Whoa.
That's big. Now are we going to see Sid?
Yes, come on. Sean, let's go. Oh, I'd love to see him bury this. Nice wrist shot. Ah.
Okay, he's going high glove side and ran out of space. Goaltender outweighed him.
Cam Brown's got 9 goals so far this season. Come on, Hafner. Let's be strong. Oh, 1-1.
1-1.
Two rounds.
Hafner guessed wrong. Came back to his forehand and roofed it.
Come on, Shaw, man.
Oh, that was pitiful.
Yeah.
He was waiting for the goalie to make a move and then snap it, and the goalie didn't make the move, and he ran out of space.
Well, when they stop their feet, Doug, and I just don't like that. I like to see the keep moving. And
well, you keep the feet moving, you keep the goalie guessing.
Brian Gratz, exact same thing. It's what he said. You see the goalie, the player's feet stop. Oh, man. Well.
Well, we got a point.
Shootout loss.
Well, Wheeling survived that one, and again, we haven't done very well in the shootouts. We had the shooters that we wanted. Just didn't get the results we wanted tonight, but the big thing was at least we got a point.
Yeah, I'm glad to see the way the boys came back and relying on Sean Sadlowski to get that monkey off his back. But Shastma, I think, was one of the leaders there, too. Of course, Shaw getting in there, and that made a difference.
Well, it comes down to in the shootout, we just need our goalies to really pick us up when we're not scoring at the other end. It puts a lot of pressure on them, but we just need the goalies to come up with that because, you know, they scored six goals in, or actually
five goals.
Well, they had two in the shootout.
Shootout, yeah.
And that, so out of basically 20 shots, they had six or seven goals. So, you know, that's not a good way to have it.
Definitely outshot them, but tough game tonight to lose in the shootout. But I'm happy with this result compared to Friday night's result. So,
well, at least we got a point. So
yep.
we take the positive out of it, build on it for we got three home games this coming weekend. We just got to get back in the win streak in our home rink. We haven't won since January 12th. Now we just got to take care of business. Come Wednesday night, we play Wichita.
Let's see what happens. We did a big game tonight, 6-5, and a shootout loss again for the Comets. We'll be back again next week, another Comet Hockey Game of the Week.